Hi guys, and welcome back to the channel. So today we're just gonna go for a walk around Caversham Wildlife Park here in Perth. So you got your admission prices here, the opening times and stuff like that. Thank you. So I'm just in the through the main kind of entry. I already sorted out payment and stuff out of that, like, you know, so I just didn't walk through. I already spoke to the ladies there. She was kind enough to give me a map, so when you do come in, make sure you grab a map and so you can find your way around. So a little shop over there. And a souvenir shop, looks like, over there. So in the video, hopefully we get up close and personal to some of the animals and feed some kangaroos. And so yeah, stay tuned guys and enjoy. The kookaburra. He's nice. And there's plenty of these little signposts around to show you where everything is. I'm gonna get the sun out of my video. There we go. Maybe I should take out my map again. Well, it looks like the kangaroos are in here. We'll go in and go and have a look. Yep, there's the sign there. Cool, I was just seeing a sign there, they have penguins. I didn't know they had penguins in here. Let's go and have a look. I suppose you got two gates here, just in case any of the little kangaroos decide to go hopping out, I suppose. There we go, alright, through here. There's a little joey down there, look at. Hello mate. So you can actually feed the kangaroos with some of these nuts here. Well, there's them. I'm trusting them in my pocket. Let's see, can we find a hungry kangaroo? Let's see, did this guy want any food? He might be hungry. Hey little dude, want some nuts? That was cool. Well, you got these beautiful little white kangaroos here. Let's see, does he want some? Hello, little fella. You want some nuts? There you go. Leave them there for you. You want some? They're so beautiful. Absolutely adorable, yeah. See, does this lad want any nuts? Morning. Want some nuts? There you go. Yeah, good job. So this area here is just for kangaroos, so we're not allowed in here. Look at that tiny little white one. Oh my god, he's tiny. You want some?
Leave them there for you, eh?
Let's see. Oh, you got two emus at the back there, see them? Oh, look at them.
Me?
Hello, little fella. Hello. Oh, he's letting me pen him, look at.
I'm just going to use this camera, whoever it is, I'm using this one.
Let's see, do you want some? You're hungry. Well, these are eating all that. Can I shake your hand? Can I shake this hand? Good job. I'll leave you some nuts there. Here. See you later.
That was digging before. I think that one has really good.
So that's the kangaroo area. Really impressed with this, guys. What do you think? Look at this little lad. Absolutely stretched out. It's loving the sun. All right, let's see what else we can find. Check out the reptiles.
Yeah.
chilling out there on the tree. A lot of snakes in the tree here, look at it. Oh, he's in there. Just under the light. There's more there. A dugong snake. Very poisonous. King Brown. This is a sometimes you just can't see them, they're hiding that good. I have to admit now, I'm not a big fan of frogs, but they're kind of cool looking. He's got yellow spots on him, so that obviously means something. Guys, that was the reptiles. Give me the kangaroos any day of the week. I wouldn't like to come across any of those reptiles out in the bush.
Enjoying meeting Australia's unique wildlife. Caversham Wildlife Park is privately owned and operated by a Western Australian family. We don't receive any funding or government assistance. We really appreciate your support.
Oh, no entry. How about going try this door?
In the meantime, don't forget to keep in touch with us.
So I haven't been in here before, so I haven't rehearsed this.
They also happens at the farm show, and most kids and grown-ups can get involved and learn all about Aussie farming. Don't forget that attraction times and locations are on the back of the map, but we're going to see one of our sample license directions. All around the farm home, please do take some of your photos, and don't forget to share the photos.
Hi guys. Hey, how you doing?
Good, yourself?
Yeah, good.
Very good.
What's his name?
This is Alf.
Hello, Alf.
Hello.
He'd wait until I walk away and then he'll say hello.
Pretty much, yeah.
What's his name?
What's his name?
Yeah.
He's Bob. Oh
hey,
no,
Bob.
This is Eric.
Oh, that's Eric.
I've got Bob in there. But yes, this is Eric. They're part of blue tongue lizards or our bobtail lizard.
They're lovely, aren't they?
Oh, no, I think they are. I think he looks like a little dragon without wings.
Yeah.
Because I find him very unique. He's got like that big fat tail. They use it to store fat when they go into hibernation down here.
Oh, right.
We get
yeah.
a bit cold down here.
Yeah.
Just kind of like a camel on its hump.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Which I didn't really find.
Where's like these guys?
These are northern blue tongues. So these guys are cousins. Very different.
Yeah.
Because these guys hibernate, they don't need to, up in the hot desert. Much more snake-like, I think, as well.
Yeah, and he flattens out there a bit, didn't
yeah.
he, when you pick him up?
Yeah. Smoother, yeah,
a
bit different.
That's great. Thanks very much.
You're very welcome.
Hello. So this is Pat Breach. It's a brush tail possum. You're welcome to have a fill of a bird. Just want to tell you if you'd like.
So soft.
Yeah.
Munching on some food.
Yeah.
Is that a he or a she?
It's a she.
She's lovely, isn't she?
Pardon?
She's lovely.
Yeah, she is sweet.
Thank you. It's so beautiful. Look at the design. All here. It's really cool looking.
Another attraction that will be visited by will be the koalas. Have you asked for a nice request for koalas in the surface? And the koala kids will be there for all of the photos. Check out the happy map for the reptiles today.
3, 2, 1.
Let's see, can we pet the snake?
Alright.
Hey, how you doing? What's this guy's name?
That's Barry, and he's
all over the place. Wow. Can I touch him?
Yeah.
Wow, you just wouldn't think it feels like that, wouldn't you know? And these are non-poisonous, are they?
Yeah, they're not poisonous.
Yeah. Wow. Cool, thanks.
Sweet potato and corn on the cob. Did you know that wombats have continuously grown teeth? A feature not found in any
other. That was cool. So it's over here. I didn't have a look.
Tree roots, that's an acre.
Oh, it's a wombat. He's down there.
But the choices we make in our everyday lives can have a huge impact on the natural Australian ecosystems and their inhabitants. Making good choices about the products we use and consume can make a significant impact to the survival of some of these great Australian animals.
You got a whole heap of bats up there hanging down, look at it. Let's see what else we can find.
Joes are born very small, between 1 to 2 centimeters in length, and they're born with their own.
And again, you've got plenty of toilets here as well. It's always good to know where the toilets are if you've got children. They have a farm show on, so there's the times there, 10 a.m, 1 p.m. and 3 p.m. I missed that. There, it just looks like you have some horses and sheep and cows.
Hello. That's not a hand sanitizer, that's water, guys. Just water.
I have some of them nuts in my pocket from feeding the kangaroos. I don't really want to go in there just in case some of the animals go a little crazy. I got two camels here on my left. There's a big population of camels up in the northern part of Australia. I've actually seen one running along one of the access roads on a mine site up north. But all these camels here in Australia, they all have originated from the Canary Islands. Believe it or not. Correct me if I'm wrong, guys. And we can hear turkeys. Hello, Mr. Alpaca. The noises of the animals is just amazing, isn't it? So small. It's lovely. So this is the bridge I walked underneath when I was in on the Kangaroo'S. I haven't been down this road yet. You got quokkas in there.
Yeah, over there.
Oh, thank you.
That's right, over in the corner.
Cheers, thank you. Oh, there he is. So if you make your way over to Rottnest Island, you'll be able to see a whole heap of quokkas, and it's well known to even get a selfie with the quokkas over there on Rottnest Island. They haven't yet been over with the camera. I'm gonna wait until the weather picks up so I can actually use the water over there on the island as well. But mind you, it's we're still just at the end of winter here at the moment, and it's 25 degrees, so it's starting to heat up. Oh, look at these penguins. They're absolutely adorable. Look at these little things. And these are native to Australia. There's a place down little south of Perth called Penguin Island, and you'll have a whole heap of these there. So let's go and have a look at the koalas. You can get your photograph taken with the koalas. I'll just show you the information here. So it's $35 a person, that's including the photo. Oh, and including your entrance fee. That's actually not too bad. And you got a big long list. I'd say residents. Wow, it's busy in here, look at it. Oh yeah, so you get your photograph. That's cool, isn't it? In the koalas, they do a lot of sleeping. Here's another Insta. Hashtag Caversham Wildlife Park. You got a big queue for the photographs, and then you got a photo opportunity there with a giant koala. Wow. Koalas are pretty busy this morning. Like, it's a Friday morning here in Perth. Well, it's nearly midday. It's like 12 o'clock in the day. This place is packed. Oh, there's a crocodile in here. He's a freshwater crocodile. And again, you'll see all them up north, up the far end of Western Australia. Oh, look at this guy. It's a beautiful colour. Just getting back to the crocodile there. I remember years ago I was up in the Kimberley region of Western Australia and crossed this bridge and I had to pull over. Just the amount of crocodiles in the water, I've never seen anything like it. Wow, he's lovely. Beautiful. He's, the eagle is all the way out the back, over there. I passed this a while ago and he was just sitting on this tree here.
Which side eagle? So this is our largest flying bird in Australia. Mm-hmm. Emu is bigger but not flying.
Oh.
You got a dingo here, look. Sunbathing. Emus. Yeah, he found them. I think that's everywhere, guys. It's just a bit of information about the park. I'm gonna put it all down in the description. And you got a picnic area. I'm sort of back at the start now. I think I've walked around about twice. There's a whole heap of other tours that hopefully I'm going to get around. Got a snack shop. Kiosk. You get some food and ice creams, cold drinks. And you got this amazing gift shop here as well. Some really nice stuff in here. So if you're around here, guys, make sure you drop in here and get yourself a souvenir. All right, guys, that's pretty much a wrap from myself. I really hope you've enjoyed Caversham Wildlife Park here in Perth. Give that like button a smack there, please, mate, as well. And if you haven't subscribed, please do so, guys. Yeah, and until next time. Slán leat.